Dear students, welcome to virtual class of Municipal Corporation of Greater Mumbai. I am Sri Kumar. The class is for 7th standard students. Subject is mathematics. Let me begin the class.
Dear students, we are getting into a new chapter in this video where you will be learning about algebraic expressions and certain operations on them. You have studied about the concept of algebraic expression last year. This year you will be learning little more about how to do certain operations in relation to algebraic expressions. Before getting into that, let us try to recollect what we learned last year. Suppose that the arrangement shown on the screen, these small squares and other things, let us consider this as small matchsticks or simple sticks. Matchsticks are better because this is some projection over here. These are matchsticks. We have made a rectangle with four matchsticks here. Two rectangle with 4 + 3 = 7 matchsticks, and here we are having three rectangles or three boxes where we are having 4 + 2 = 6 + 4 = 10 matchsticks. This is an arrangement. Sometimes we play with matchsticks, then we feel like making squares and rectangles with matchstick. The same way. Now, if you study this particular arrangement of sticks, and we try to convert what I told into numbers. In the first row, we are having one square or one rectangle here. Let it be square because the matchstick is of same size. So there is one square over here. In the second column, we are having two squares. Here it is three square. We can add the number of matchstick and increase the number of squares. We can do it. We know it. And if we study further, first column which contain only one square is made up of four matchsticks. The second column which contain two squares is made up of seven matchsticks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Third one is made up of 10 matchsticks. Understood? So the number of matchsticks when one square, when we move to two squares, it is not doubling. Here it is 4, here it is 7. When three squares are there, 10 matchsticks. Without making square, it is written 13 over here. You have to check it whether it is right or not. To make four squares, 13 matchsticks are required. On studying this data further, we understand that when 3 + 1 matchsticks used, we could make one square. Then 6 + 1 matchstick when we used, we could make two squares. 9 + 1 matchstick, we could make three squares. तो क्या relationship थी? इधर 3 है, इधर 6 है, इधर 9 है. इसलिए हो सकती है 12 + 1 लिख डाला. That is why 13 came. Because we understood the pattern or nature of the number. Or we can say that 3 × 1 square + 1 is the number of matchstick required in the first case. 3 × 2 + 1 is the number of matchstick required for making two squares. 3 × 3 + 1 is the number of matchstick required for making three squares. So if we continue like that, 3 × 10 + 1 will be required here in this case for making 10 squares. Correct? Like that we got an idea. When we have to make 4 squares, 3 × 4 + 1. In that case, if we have to make 10 squares, we will use 3 × 10 + 1, 31 matchsticks will be used. Correct? And if that is the case, why can't we think 3 into number of squares required plus 1 will be the number of matchsticks required. Correct? 3 into number of squares you require. If you need 2, you will write 3 into 2 plus 1, you will take 7 matchsticks and prepare this 2 squares, because you require 2 squares. Understood? So there is a pattern followed, there is a connection between these. And we brought an alphabet here and we wrote 3 into n plus 1. Jab alphabet aaya to humko idea aa gaya. Whenever we use alphabet to represent these kind of unknown numbers or supposed numbers, such expressions we named as algebraic expression in 6th standard. That means we can write this as 3n plus 1, which is an algebraic expression, because there is a unknown quantity represented by a alphabet and which can vary, and we call it as variable, which you have studied last year. 3 into number of squares plus 1 is the pattern here. If you do not know the number of squares, we write a letter in its place. Number of squares required is n here. Here the number of squares is shown in the form of n. N is a variable. Just remember that. 3 into n plus 1, which is the same as 3n plus 1, which is an algebraic expression. Ye aapko fundamental samajhna hai. Here there will be 4 squares and last case it will be 10 squares, there will be n squares. So my dear students, what is on the screen is fundamentally telling you, you can formulate this kind of algebraic expression to resolve and solve certain situations. Understood? So take time, you can pause the video and try to understand what I told, and what your, this is what is from your textbook only, so naturally what your textbook is trying to make you understand, follow that perfectly, then go ahead. If you want, you can fill in the blanks over here, you can write imagine, or if you are more interested and having enough interest to do this, you can do it with matchstick and experiment whether for making 10 squares, 31 matchsticks are required. If not, at least for 4 squares, can check there whether 13 matchsticks will be required. Like that, you can take more interesting step in this case. Then you will go ahead to the next part of the video. Now, things are becoming simple. 3 balls are there. 3 balls. 1, 2, 3. 3 triangles. So if I am writing 3 triangles like this, is there an issue? No issue. We understand 3 T's are the T's represent triangles. Correct? Which is something very common and known to us. Suppose that there are balls and bat and together 2 balls and 3 bats. You have 2 mangoes and 3 guavas. And if I represent ball in the form of X and guavas as Y, or mangoes as X and guavas as Y, balls as X and bat as Y, why can't I write it as 2X plus Y? These are all algebraic expressions where we will write X is nothing but balls and all Ys are bats. We can write. We can say 2 balls, 3 bats, 2 mangoes, 3 guavas, can represent algebraic expression form mein waisa likh sakte hain. Correct? And if it is a rectangle having a length and breadth like this, and if we are asked to find out its perimeter of a rectangle is 2 times length plus 2 times breadth, why can't we write it as 2 into L plus B, 2L plus 2B first and then 2 into 2L plus B. We are converting those unknown length and breadth into alphabets and writing in the form of an algebraic expression. And we do addition with that. But we should get the length and breadth to do operation. So my dear students, maths becoming a little bit practical here. We found 3n plus 1 in the first case, 3t over here, 2x plus y in this case, 2l plus b in this case. All these are algebraic expressions. And in this, n we don't know, t we don't know, number l, b, x are variables. These are variables. English, in English, vary means change. It can change. T is a triangle here. Its number is 3 here. It can be the T can be something other, trees also. X can be anything, which we will say and decide and apply. But we can apply and solve the situation and find solution. In the expression 3x, 3 is the coefficient, x is the variable. 3 is the coefficient, x is the variable. Okay. 3 is the variable, x is the variable. 3 is the coefficient. Coefficient means which gives efficiency to the variable. Coefficient. Chalo, we'll learn a little more about it. If the in the expression minus 15t. Minus 15 is the coefficient and variable is t. Okay? In the expression, such expression, sometimes it will be minus, sometimes it is plus. An expression which only multiplication is there. This is ka matlab kya hai? 3x matlab 3 into x minus 15t is ka matlab kya hai? Minus 15 into t. If multiplication is the only operation, we call it as a term. So 3x is a term, minus 15t is a term. Then what is not a term or what will be considered as separate terms, we will come to that. An algebraic expression may have one term or many, depending upon, it can be sum of several terms. It can be sum of several terms or it can be a collection of terms. For example, 11mn is a having coefficient 11 and variables mn. Minus 9x square y cube minus 9, these coefficient x and y are variables. Because only multiplication is involved. In the case of 5 upon 6p, 5 upon 6 is coefficient, p is variable. A, simply A, where is the coefficient? The coefficient is 1 in such cases. Please note. This has to be noted. Here, we should consider the coefficient as 1. Now, in the algebraic expression where 4x square minus 2y plus 5 upon 6. Tension matlab ko solve nahi karna hai. 4x square is the first term because only operation is multiplication. Minus 2y is the second term. 5 upon 6 into xz, this is the third term. There are three terms in this. 1, 2, 3. So an algebraic expression can have more than one term. An algebraic expression can have more than one term. Understood? We will go ahead. Now, the algebraic expression 15 minus x is having two terms. 15 is the number. Right? Minus x is a term, which is another second term. First term is 15. Beech mein kya hai? Minus x. Iska matlab aisa hai. Abhi main iske upar likhne se galat nahi samajh. Ye minus is subtraction ka hai. X. Understood? Now, here the coefficient of variable x is minus 1. Jab aap dekhenge iska bhi ek coefficient chahiye, that will become minus 1, like before. Now, term which have the same variable with same power are called like terms. Wo kya hota hai? Terms like bhi ho sakte hai in an expression. For example, 2x, 5x, माइनस 2/3x, इसमें सब वेरिएबल सेम है, सो ऑल दिस आर कॉल्ड लाइक टर्म्स। एक्स स्क्वायर वाई मतलब x टू द पावर ऑफ 2 एंड y, हियर y एक्स स्क्वायर उसका मतलब भी y वन टाइम x, वो था सेम टर्म्स, सो दे आर लाइक टर्म्स। लाइक टर्म्स विल बी हैविंग सेम वेरिएबल्स, लाइक टर्म्स विल बी हैविंग सेम वेरिएबल, प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड दैट, ओके। Unlike terms will be having different variable. Here is a term xy, दूसरे का term y square है, तीसरे का term my xyz है. So these are unlike terms. Mn, m square n square, m cube n. Other अलग अलग type का variables है, so we call it as unlike terms. So there are like terms and unlike term concept in this. Now, depending upon the number of terms in an algebraic expression, we have divided algebraic expression into monomial, binomial, trinomial and polynomials. Monomial, mono means single, bi means two, tri means three, three triangle ko three side, poly means many. Monomial will be having only one term, all these are having one term, these are having two terms, these are having three terms. These are having more than three terms. Please understand. These are the three terms. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And there is no like terms. A cube, A square, B, C. Here, you are having 1, 2, 3. Usse zyada. 1, 2, 3. ट्राइनोमियल से आगे सब पॉलिनोमियल बोलेंगे, 1, 2, 3, अंडरस्टूड। सो द अल्जेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशन कैन बी नेम्ड एज मोनोमियल इफ देर इज वन टर्म, बाइनोमियल टू टर्म्स, थ्री टर्म्स इफ देर इज, ट्राइनोमियल मोर देन थ्री टर्म्स वी कॉल इट एज पॉलिनोमियल। I would like to stop this video because the next part of the lesson is something different and application. So my dear students, what is meant by an algebraic expression? What is meant by a term? What is meant by like terms and unlike terms? What is meant by monomial, binomial, trinomial, polynomial? This is what is this video is about. But very very important fundamental aspect of algebra, so you should be very clear and thorough about this concept. In this, unlike terms, like terms are having lot of importance, because when you go next into the addition and subtraction of algebraic expression, only like terms can be added and subtracted, so you should know what is like term and unlike term. Polynomial is going to be a very important chapter for you, important lesson for you in future, because polynomials help us to solve difficult situations in future in mathematics. So my dear students, take interest to understand the basic concept of algebraic expression through this video. Watch the video again and again, get into the textbook, read the textbook, copy something into the notebook, write down in your notes and understand, make boxes, make decoration and keep it in your mind to apply when time comes. Thank you. Now click on the subscription button below to subscribe the channel, then the bell button to get the notifications of the new videos. Thank you. Click on the subscription button below to subscribe the channel, then the bell button to get the notifications of the new videos. Thank you.